this, they give us this equation y equals 2x plus 3. They say that that represents the cost of shipping a package through the mail. They don't really give much explanation other than that. They just say that that represents the cost where that's the cost, the total cost. And this is the number of pounds that the package weighs. First wants us to graph the equation. How can we graph this equation? This is we can always get a fairly decent graph by doing this thing, Robert.
Like we can make the x and the y.
Right.
Then on the x side or on the y side, we can do 2 times 0 plus 3.
So for x, we plug in
0.
0. 2 times 0 plus 3. That's 0 plus 3. It's 3, right? Doesn't get any easier. Remember that was the blue ribbon. First place award for our easiest thing to plug in for x. So you plug in 0 for x. Should really have out your notes, taking notes. You're sitting there staring at the screen. So we plug in 0, we get 3. Because, well, it's just convenient to plug in 0 because it eliminates that term with the x in it. And all that's left is this thing that's being added on. Then what should we do? Robert?
We also do 1.
We can plug 1 in there. Okay. Since this is just a 2, right? It's not a fraction, it's just a 2. Whatever we plug in for x, it's not going to be very difficult. 1's pretty easy because 2 times 1 is 2. And 2 plus 3 is 5. So 1 comma 5. So our line is going to go through those 2 points. There we go. Wow. So we graphed it. So you can see that for a 0 pound package, this is kind of a ridiculous idea, but for a 0 pound package, it would cost $3. How much would it cost for a 1 pound package to ship it through the mail?
$5.
How much would it cost for a 2 pound package?
Seven.
It would cost $2 more.
Yeah.
Right? Every time we add on a pound, how many dollars do we add on?
Two.
Very good. Yeah. We add on $2 more if we were to add on another pound, and so it goes. On and on and on it goes for as many pounds as we want to talk about, except for maybe negative pounds. Then it asks to use the graph, so we've graphed it, we're going to use the graph to estimate how much it costs to mail the package, okay? It's referring to a picture of a scale. The scale reads 1.126 pounds. So there's a package on a digital scale. The digital scale reads 1.126 pounds. If we were to use the graph, right, here's 1.126, it's just barely bigger than 1. And go up to the y value, there it is. About how much is this y value here, approximately?
David?
1.126. That's the x value. The y value.
Oh.
Yes?
4.126?
Oh, I know.
4.126. 1, 2, 3, 4.126 is right about there. Is that where our point is?
5.126.
Don't be misled. Don't think that just because our x value has a 0.126 on it, that our y value will have a 0.126 on it. Okay? It might. In some cases. In this particular case, it definitely doesn't. Okay? Just because it says 1.126, don't think that that means that this is going to be 5.126. But it's not going to be too far away from 5.126, right? It's going to be in that neighborhood. Robert?
5.226.
5.226. We're just making decent guesses here, yeah?
Five.
And so it's around 5.226, 5.126. It's in that neighborhood, right? We're just guessing, really. We're estimating, and that's what it's asking us to do. Okay? So our estimation, it might be 5.226. It might be 5 exactly. It would be 5.126. These are all our estimates. We're estimating that the cost of a package that is just barely bigger than 1 pound is going to be just barely bigger than $5 to ship. Then it says to use the equation to find exactly how much it's going to cost for a package that's 1.126 pounds. How will we use the equation to find exactly how much it costs to ship a package that's 1.126 pounds? Get it?
2 times 1.26 plus 3.
Yep. We're just using equation. Plug that value of pounds in for x. 1.126 times 2.
2 times 1.126.
Calculator. 2 times 1.126 plus 3. 5.252. Is that close to our estimate?
Yes.
It certainly is. It's very close. Closest probably to 5.226. Okay, so good estimate. Good use of the graph to make that estimate, good use of the equation to find exactly the amount that it's going to cost for that package. Any questions about that? Emma? What's that? Did you say 5.25?
No.
I guess we're talking about exact. Well, in real life, how much would you be charged? 5.25. You would be charged 5.25 and 0.2 cents. But if we could be exact about money, that would be exactly right. All right. Any questions? Any additional questions about that? Okay. Let's make sure we have our notes out now. I'm going to do a homework review on those two questions. Get right into it. A little activity that I need you to at least need to be creative about it. Okay? You can think about. No, I don't know. Okay. Let me just take these out of here so we just concentrate on this equation, and I want you to tell a story that could go with the following equation. Okay? Tell a story. The homework was two stories, two examples of stories that went with equations. So what I want you to do for a couple of minutes, maybe if you find a story, think of a story, think of another story. Right? Now, probably there's going to be some stories that work, but that aren't quite what I'm looking for. Right? I mean, I'm going to hone in on exactly what I'm looking for. So I want you to think about a story that can fit this equation. What are we talking about?
I think so.
We're all listening to Jackson now.
So, graph the average amount the dragon weighs. I don't know how I read this. Graph the average amount a dragon weighs a month after being born if the dragon grows 5 pounds a month and 1 more pound the last day of the month.
Okay. Could we change it maybe so that the dragon starts out at 1 pound? When it's born, it just weighs 1 pound? Could we do that? Okay. That helps us out with when we think about these equations if it starts out at 1 pound. Okay, so I want you to listen to what Jackson said. He made, let's put Jackson here. Let's just put some specifics, right? He said 5 what?
Dragons.
5 dragons, 5 pounds. More to it. When you read it, you said it. What's that?
A dragon. Isn't it 5 pounds of dragon?
5 pounds of dragon.
Not Jackson,
more.
Dragon.
A month. Per month is the very important part that I was looking for. 5 pounds per month. Okay? Not just 5 pounds, and not just $5, and not just five whatever, but 5 pounds every time a month goes by is what I'm talking about. All right. And then one, so it's 1 pound, 1 pound at birth, which is a pretty small dragon. It's in the dragon.
It's a big dragon.
Yeah, I weighed 8.
Maybe it's a little dragon.
Oh, I thought that said something.
I weighed 10 pounds.
Wait, did you still weigh that? I was 7.12.
Hello? It was going so well. Lost our minds.
Oh, that's cool.
Let's not lose our minds this time. Caden?
Can I tell my story?
Yes, tell your story, absolutely.
Okay. So, Y equals how many pizza pieces of pizza are in the box? And then...
Okay.
5 equals how many friends, all the friends that are over eating pizza.
Can you talk about switching these?
Yeah, but 3 friends don't eat 5 pieces of pizza. It's a little excessive.
No one has
I
a
would eat 5 pieces of
pizza. Okay, fine.
Yeah, me and
5 pieces of pizza with X amount of friends.
So 5 pieces of, now 5 pieces of pizza what?
Per person.
Per
friend.
And there's plus one.
And then plus one, the dog ate it off the box.
So. And so one, the dog ate.
Yeah.
I'm doing minus one then.
Yeah.
So
no,
I think rather than saying maybe.
Confused.
rather than saying that are in the box, because in the box would mean that they're still there. So maybe pieces, just pieces that are gone.
Consumed.
Right?
Yeah.
So here. I guess you should have written this down. Why is the pounds of dragon total? And X, what was X?
Months.
X
the number
is
of
how many
months. And for you, what was X?
X is how many friends you have.
X is how many friends are over.
Friends are over, not
friends. You're over, okay. And Y represented what?
How many pieces of pizza are consumed?
Pieces consumed. Okay, here are 2 good examples. We don't need a ton of examples. The important part here is that these kinds of what we call functions, this is really called a function, okay, we're looking at this guy here to be what we call a rate of change. As one thing changes, it causes another thing to change. Okay? The months are changing, which causes, I don't know that it causes, but there's a correlation between the months going by and what?
The weight of the dragon.
The weight of the dragon in pounds. Here we have a relationship between, as the number of friends increases, what?
The
number of pieces consumed is increased. Okay? So as I increase months, the pounds increase. As the number of friends increase, the number of pieces increase. At a rate of 5 pounds per month, 5 pieces per friend. Okay. Where else do we hear that something per something? Where else do you hear that in everyday life, Dalton?
Months per gallon.
Thank you, Dalton.
Gallons of gas.
Gallons per dollar. Maybe if we go the other way, dollars per gallon. This is where we hear that. Or the miles per gallon. Right? We hear that. Miles per hour.
Oh.
Meters per second. We hear it. What about that? What's that?
Gallons per mile.
I hope it's not gallons per mile. That's
it was.
Okay. You should get multiple miles to a gallon. How about dollars per hour when I'm at work? Dollars per hour, Robert?
RPM.
Revolutions per minute should really be called RSPM.
Kilometers
per hour if you're Canadian. Okay.
I'm Canadian.
Or anywhere but American, I guess. So we're looking for a kind of rate. Okay. And now, what would you say about this little guy right here? That's not a rate. What might you call that? Borrowing from these 2 examples. The an additional amount, maybe a starting point, maybe an initial value, maybe, you know, we can call it a lot of different things, right? So now that you've seen a couple of really great examples, I want you to come up with your own example. Come up with your own example for the following function. There.
How does that
seem? Wait this way. So come up with a story for that one. Alright. So let's hear Carter. You share a story with me. What'd you say?
Yeah. Okay, I put Y is how many months. How tall the seed was after it got done growing.
Okay, and when a seed grows, then it's called a plant, right? So
yeah.
The height of a plant.
How tall the plant grew.
Yeah.
And then 3 is how many inches it grew. And then X.
Well, not quite. Let's go back to that 3. You said it differently when I was standing right there.
It was, I can't remember what it was.
3 inches.
It was 3 inches, how many?
How often?
In a
month, yes, 3 inches every month. Do you see that rate coming up again?
Yeah.
The rate, 3 inches per month.
And then X was how many months it was?
X was how many months?
Which was 4. I put 4 in.
No, we don't need any specifics.
Oh.
But if we wanted to use your function to figure out how tall it was after 4 months, that's exactly what we would do.
And then we cut 6 inches off.
So, okay, so for some reason, this negative 6, like, good, it's a loss, right?
Yeah.
It's a negative amount, okay? Maybe, how could we represent this, like, how could this negative 6 be represented in the beginning, right, at 0 months? How could it be represented at the very beginning, at 0 months, for
maybe
the height of this plant?
Like, how long it took for it to grow?
Well, see, when we take 3 inches per month times the number of months, we should get inches here. So this should probably be a number of inches,
yeah,
right, not a length of time.
So it was 6 inches into the ground.
We pushed it 6 inches into the ground. It's in a hole.
Yeah.
That is 6 inches under the ground to start with. Very good. So negative 6 inches, right? So that's like it's in a 6-inch
hole
to start with. So how long does it take before you even see it above the ground?
It takes
2 months.
2 months. At 2 months, you might see a little speck of green at the very surface of the ground. Okay? That's a great story. That's a great story. How about Zach?
Okay. Avery shot 3 times as many elk as me. But 6 were confiscated by fishing game.
Okay.
Avery,
now, I'm going to ask you to bear with me here because we need to think. Now, what is X then?
How many I shot.
Okay, so this is Zach's elk. Now, remember at the beginning I said I'm not looking for stories that are such and such is 3 times as such and such. Remember that?
Yeah.
But it's not wrong, it's just that I think we're a little more ready for it. It's just a little tricky to turn this into a rate, okay? So the rate here is really smaller. So I want you to think about all the rates we've talked about. We talked about dollars per hour, meters per second, here's inches per month. Pounds per month, pieces of pizza per friend, and now what we have is 3 elk per
person
year.
Elk.
Yeah.
3 elk per elk. Let's call it three Avery elk.
No, 3 American.
3 elk.
The story is about Avery and Zach.
No, 3 true elk.
Right?
Yeah.
Right, Zach? Okay, so 3 Avery elk. for every one of Zach's elf. So three ale per zelf. That's hard to say. You see what I'm saying? The rate is, the units in the numerator and denominator are the same, elk and elk. But it works. It just would have been probably a little more confusing if we had started with an example like that. But the elk per elk works too. And so now, oh, but six were confiscated.
Fishing game.
Illegally shot on private land.
C-O-N-F-I-S.
Yeah. Okay.
Sure. I think so.
Okay, that works. I mean,
it's
yeah, sure. That works pretty well. I don't know if you can have six elk confiscated by Fish and Wildlife.
You said
imagination.
Still be in not jail.
He shot them
in prison.
Okay, we're going to go with these two for now, okay? But I want you to notice the difference between, I'm tired of shining over you, I'm talking, please pay attention, hands down. Okay, we got two good stories here, Carter and Avery. And I want you to notice the difference between this and the previous example. What's the difference between this and the previous example?
They said times.
What's that?
Zach said
times.
There's a subtraction there. We started out with like negative six elk. We started out with negative 6 inches, whereas the previous example, we started out with a positive amount. We started out, the dog had eaten one piece. We started out, the dragon already weighed 1 pound, right? So now we start out at a.
But it still kind of makes sense, though, doesn't it? Like it could work.
No, absolutely it works. Yeah.
You mind?
But that's why we have to deal. That's what we have to do to deal with the negative, the subtraction of six. We have to see it as well.
Yeah.
We started out with a negative amount.
Yeah.
Right.
All
right.
Okay.
Question.
Do you mind?
No.
For the Friday's one, if it was like.
Listen, please.
If the pet was like 9 inches tall and then cut off 6 inches, would that be okay too?
Well, we'll see as we progress through this. It's, like I said, helpful to think about that, this guy right here, as kind of a starting point where it starts off. And then from there, we just see the number go up. Okay? And you'll see why. You'll see why.
I don't even know if mine makes
me so boring. All right. Let's write a third story. You're learning really important things here. As long as you're paying attention and taking good notes, you're learning really important things here. Okay, I'll fade this out. This one up there. I want to see the story for this equation, and I would like for it to be relatively quiet as each person thinks about their story.
Wait, okay.
Tiana?
You drew 6 inches.
Please listen to Tiana. It is not difficult. Every time someone's talking, I ask you to listen to them. Someone's talking, so please listen to them. Tiana?
You drew 6 inches into the ground every month.
6 inches?
Yeah, every 4 inches, sorry.
Okay, drill
4 inches
per month.
Yeah, per month. And then one day, any day, any day in this possible month, or any month, an animal puts 2 inches back into your, back
okay,
into your dirt.
Okay, so 2 inches falls back in.
It's a negative.
What's negative about this situation?
Because it goes in there.
You're drilling down, right? Your height is going down.
Not that you could really drill up, but.
Right?
You can drill into the ceiling.
So then what does Y represent?
Still
y represents how deep your hole is.
Okay, the depth. Okay. The depth, and X represents?
The amount of dirt you pulled out.
Is that right?
X is how many months?
X is how many months have gone by. Good. Hey, Sarah. How's it going?
Good.
It's going okay.
Do you have a story, Sarah?
Hi, Nate.
Okay, let's hear it.
Okay, so for every 4 you add 2. For every 4 you use.
For before what?
Beads you use.
Beads!
Bracelet.
Like bracelet.
Beads?
For every 4 beads. beads you use, you add two.
Yeah, so it's like.
But you're losing them. Let's see.
Yeah, so you
put
them
in
something
back. Exactly. Where do those beads come from? So the notice the two here. It astounds me that people can sit here, look across the room, talk to each other, write nothing down, and then be confused later and complain about it. Take notes, ask questions, stop talking to each other. So, how about if we said something like, we use four beads per what?
Bracelet.
Per bracelet, sure, that works. Per bracelet. Okay. And so what would X represent?
How many bracelets?
How many bracelets you've made, or you plan to make? Number of bracelets. And what does Y represent?
How many
total beads? Well, it would be more like total beads that you have, because you're losing the number of beads, right? The number of beads is going down. So number of beads you have. Okay, now there's two. Sometimes writing these stories, but those are a very good example, good job. Sometimes the stories are, like, they don't really work perfectly.
Oh.
Yeah, but we're doing the best we can do with the equation I've given to you. But this would be like we have two beads to start with. Or maybe somebody gives us two beads at some point or something like that.
From like the first bracelet you made.
Okay, you have two extra. Okay, that works too. You had two extra from, you know, yesterday or something like that. Okay? The thing that I want you to notice is we've done three examples and they've all looked like this. Y equals a rate times X plus, let's say, like an initial amount. An amount that we start with. Okay, have a good day, everybody.